Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you different ways you can switch between apps on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So often on your Mac, you're using more than one app at a time. But there's not enough room on the screen to keep all those windows there, and the windows for those apps will either overlap each other or cover each other completely. So you often need to switch between apps, bring one app's windows to the front ahead of other windows. There are several ways to do this. So here you can see I've got a mess of windows with different apps that are running. If I wanted to bring one to the front and I could see it, all I need to do is click on it somewhere. Like for instance, here I can click on the calendar window and it will bring calendar to the front. Then I could click on Safari, bring Safari ahead of that. But often you can't see all of the windows for your apps, or you can't see them clearly enough to know which is which. You could simply do the same thing that you would do to run the app. If the app is already running, then it will simply bring that app to the front. So for instance, I can go down to the dock here and notice that I have a dot under each app that's currently running. So if I want to bring one to the front, like say Notes, I can click on it in the dock. Now if Notes wasn't running, it would launch Notes. But since it's already running, all it does is bring it to the front. And in fact, you can use any method that you normally use to launch an app to also bring it to the front. So for instance, I can go to Launchpad here and I can click Calendar, and it simply brings Calendar to the front since it was already running. Or if I wanted to bring Pages to the front, I could use Command Space to launch Spotlight, search for Pages, and then press return just like I wanted to launch Pages. Now this technique is handy when you're not sure whether or not the app's already running. For instance, maybe I was using Pages hours ago and I don't remember if I quit it or if the app is simply buried behind other windows. So just trying to launch Pages will accomplish your task of bringing Pages there to the front if it's already running or launching it if it's not. I don't have to worry about which one because it works in either case. Now another way to switch between apps is to use the App Switcher, which is built just for this. Using the App Switcher involves the Command key and the Tab key on your keyboard. What you want to do is hold down the Command key first, and with that held down, tap the Tab key. This brings up the App Switcher. You have to keep the Command key held down. And notice that the app I was previously running is automatically selected. So Calendar was the frontmost app, but by doing Command Tab, now Pages is selected. If I press Tab again, it moves to Notes. Press it again, it continues to move down the line. In fact, if you go all the way to the end of the list and then Tab one more time, it goes back to the beginning. So now you could select which app you want to bring to the front, then release the Command key, and that app will pop to the front. You could also go backwards in this list by using Command Tab to bring it up, but then holding the Shift key down and then using Tab, and it will go backwards through the list. Or use Command Tab to bring it up, and then with the Command key still held down, switch to the key above the Tab key, the one with the back tick or tilde character on it. Then you go backwards. You can't start the App Switcher this way, but if you start it with Command Tab and then use that key, you'll go backwards through the list. Now all these techniques will also work if you've hidden the app. So for instance, for Notes here, I go to Notes and then Hide Notes, or just Command H. Now Notes is hidden, but it's still running. I could see the dot under it there. Any of these techniques, like selecting it here in the dock or using the App Switcher, will unhide the app. However, that's not the case if you minimize a window. If I click the yellow button here, it minimizes that Notes window. It's now here in the dock. Now I could switch to another app, say by clicking on that window. If I were to Command Tab to Notes, I go back to Notes, but that window is still minimized. It's still down here in the dock, and I have to bring it up in order to see that window again. Another good reason to hide instead of using the minimize feature. Now what about full screen apps or when you have multiple desktops? So let's take Notes to full screen, and then to switch back to all of the other apps that are on the main desktop, I can use Control and up arrow, and I could see Mission Control here with that desktop and Notes. But I could also just use Control, left, and right arrows to go between desktops, including full screen apps. So if I were to take several of these full screen, and now I could see I've got three full screen apps here, I could switch between them by using Control and then right arrow or left arrow, including the desktop that has all the remaining windows on it. But if I use the App Switcher, it will automatically take me to the right desktop or the full screen app. So Command Tab, and I'll go to Notes. And when I release the Command key, you can see it takes me over to that full screen window of Notes. So that's a look at several different ways that you could switch between apps. So which is the one you should use? Well, the App Switcher is the primary one that most Mac users use. So practice using Command Tab if you're not already doing it to switch between your apps. It's the quickest way, and you'll notice that if there are two apps you're switching back and forth between, they're always the first two apps shown there in the App Switcher. So quick Command Tab goes to one, then Command Tab goes back to the other.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.